I'm Chris Berry. I'm a science teacher. My area of teaching is physics and marine studies, but I teach junior science as well under the new Australian curriculum. The school is St Mary's College in Wollongong. We're an all-girls Catholic school, but we're an independent school run by the Good Samaritan Sisters.
What we've looked at so far in this topic is atoms. We've looked at where they're structured on the periodic table. We looked at how they're structured. So protons and neutrons in the nucleus, electrons in the shells around the outside. Where we're moving into is what happens when we put these atoms, these elements together, okay? So we're going to start by having a look at some chemical reactions.
I wanted them to see a chemical reaction of their own. I wanted them to perform it themselves with minimal instruction from me. Once they can do it themselves, they own it in themselves and they will more readily hold on to that information. The Science by Doing resources are excellent. They're structured in a bright, easy to read way. So I have it on the students' iPads and they have that on their desk as their instructions. If it's not a practical experiment, they have different activities, different resources, different interactives that the students can access instead of just searching on Google and hoping they find the correct answer. They're still finding the information, but it is a selected set of information, something that is tailored to what they're doing.
When we do these reactions, you're going to write down observations. When you do an observation, what do you observe with?
Your eyes.
Your eyes. Yeah, you're looking at something. You're looking for something to change. What else do you observe with? The smell. Yeah, things might change. Things might change smell. What else? What else can you make an observation with? What organs can you make an observation? Your mouth? You make an observation with your mouth? You can taste it, that's right. What else can you, yeah? Your ears, so there's an organ there so that you can hear, see, you can hear if there's a change. Make an observation there. Ada, sorry? And touch, to see if something changes temperature or might change texture. Now today, we're not gonna be smelling, we're not gonna be tasting. So follow just test one. Once you've seen what happens, write down your observations. Go for it. Figure out which ones you need?
Yeah.
Copper, sulfate. Yep. Sodium hydroxide. Cool. Make sure you're reading and working out how much you need of each. Great question. Why is it going clumpy? There's a solid. You put in two liquids and suddenly there's a solid. Yeah. That's what I'll be writing down.
We use a process called notebooking. So while they use a table that's going to be similar for all of them, the way they do it is up to them. And they might write extra notes on the side or might draw a diagram of what they saw, and that's totally fine. The idea is that their books become unique to them. And it's not, they're not just carbon copies of everybody else's. The more engaging I made my lesson, the more practical I made my lesson, the more the students thought about what they were doing themselves, the more success I had anyway.
So here's something weird. What colour was that? Oh, sorry, that one there, blue. What colour's, oh, was that one, okay. What colour's this?
Clear.
Clear? And what have you got now? Blue what?
Like a dark blue, oh, and it's clear down the bottom.
Yeah. Yeah, so we had a blue liquid and a clear liquid, and now we've got a blue solid and a, what is it, kind of a greeny colour liquid? What happened? When blue and lumpy, you saw a solid appear. So the sign of a chemical change there is you saw a solid appear. Now, we don't use the word solid in chemistry. It has a special word, okay? Let's see if you've learnt this word yet. Precipitate. You've made a precipitate. That means a solid has come out of solution. That's a sign of a chemical change. If you see a precipitate, you know a chemical change has happened. Second one you did, what did you see happen?
Under the old system, we would introduce a topic and give them some information and then try and prove it using a practical example. It's kind of been swapped around a bit now. So with the inquiry approach, you encourage them to experience it themselves, and then from that they draw a conclusion which you guide along the way.